What are you starving for?
I'm starving for your hugs and kisses, Alia. I mentioned them in episode after episode of F and Baby, but
I'm not an affectionate person.
But that's why I'm starving for it. There's no water, so I'm thirsty.
You have 2 children and 5 dogs. Where you find a way to get it?
Your hugs and kisses, Alia, with your kisses on my cheek and your arm around me. That's when I come and I sneak in the morning sometimes.
Because
that's when she's vulnerable, you know, because she's forgotten she's out.
She takes advantage of me. She takes advantage of me. My mother takes advantage of me in the morning.
She's this sleepy, sweet space where she's still this little girl inside, and then I crawl into her bed, and then she turns around and she puts her hand across me like this, and that whole feeling of oh my god, I just put.
I am locking my room door from today.
She puts her arm around me, and then
oh
I get this.
Oh my god, what is wrong with
then
you? Are you okay?
And I'm fine. That those moments are so
fine. Oh my god, you know this. And then no, stop.
It's special to
stop.
Me.
It's weird. It is special to me. I'm locking my room door. Please ask me my question.
She's. I can understand you're not affectionate as Alia M, but how can you grudge the fact
please
that when I come to my affection and you give me affection? Alia,
ask me question.
Alia is like this really last minute person, right? So Alia is always racing against time and racing against deadlines, and everything is like, I perform best under pressure is her belief system. So she waits in the last minute to create the pressure because, it's all self-performing.
It's an excuse, I'll tell you what happens. I procrastinate a lot. And so to justify my procrastination, I say I work best under pressure.
But I think
I only work under pressure. No, my thing is I only work under pressure. Not that I work best under pressure, I only work under pressure.
Yeah, and that belief system makes you keep creating the fact that you leave everything to the last minute.
That's procrastination.
Anyway, so my next question to you is that if you were leaving right now on a road trip, like right now, what would
you do? How does that have to do procrastination?
Because you're so good at performing under pressure, leaving right now.
My answer is so boring. I'd probably take my phone and clothes and music.
See, even now she didn't mention me. This is what I'm saying.
But no, I wouldn't want to go on a road trip with you. You and me in a car for hours? We would go insane. We could kill each other. Only one of us would reach the destination.
I don't even know how to respond to that because it's like so cruel.
Firstly, our music taste would differ. Like firstly, we'd kill each other over
firstly,
that. If we wouldn't kill each other over that, we'd kill each other because we'd both be sleep deprived, and then we'd both be snapping at each other because we both love sleep. Then you'd be forcing me to eat stuff I don't like. So you'd be stopping at a weird place and you'd be like, eat this and eat that. Well, I've tried this and it's so good and it's actually really bad. And I'll have to like say, oh, it's nice. And I'll get irritated, so I won't eat as much. So I'll be food deprived.
I'll be hungry.
I'll be hungry. So I'll start snapping. Then after snapping, she'll be like, oh, Alia, you're always picking on me. You're always on my case. You're always attacking me. And then I'll be like, I'm not attacking you. I'm just tired and hungry. And she'll be like, why are you tired and hungry? You're tired because you don't do your work on time. Tired because you're taking me on a road trip.
No, oh, so the same road trip would have been with her friends. So it won't be like, oh, my friends are taking me on a road trip. But it's like, oh my god, my mother is taking me on a road
my
trip.
My friends don't accuse me of attacking them. My friends don't. We have the same music taste. If I say let's not stop here,
I listen to your music. You haven't even made me hear this favorite anthem song of yours.
I love it. I'm sure you've heard it.
No.
Yeah, I'm sure you've heard it. It's on the radio all the time.
I'm just saying.
I'm sure you've heard it.
I'm just saying.
You just don't remember it because you
have. I've never said you don't. Alia, I've never said I don't like your music. You don't like my music. But I've never said I don't like your music. I love reggae and I love
my music. You know what she does? It's really strange, okay? So, like, I get really scared about the music I play. Like, see, normally, the music you play, like, you like the way it sounds, right? You don't actually go deep into the lyrics and analyze the lyrics and say, oh, because of these lyrics, I like the song. Like, sometimes, yeah, not all the time, right? So, sometimes I just play a song, or if it's on shuffle, and a song starts playing, and she'll sit there, she'll analyze the lyrics and think that that's my current mindset. And she's like, Alia, is everything okay? Talk about anything, I'm there, baby. Are you fine? I'll be like, yeah. Why? She's like, no, I'm just asking. And then I realize the background say something or something is playing. I'll just be like, oh, that's why. So I'm very careful for songs that play next to her. It's just like, yeah. So it's called psychoanalysis or something.